Member.
Thank you. Honorable Speaker. On Monday this week, when the Attorney General was asked why an accused drug-dealing thug was able to walk free from court in British Columbia because of a shortage of sheriffs, she said it was an anomaly. Well, Honorable Speaker, that anomaly occurred again yesterday when, in Supreme Court, a serial heroin-dealing thug was allowed to walk free because of a shortage of sheriffs. And when he was told he could go free, he smiled. He laughed. He thought it was a joke. I don't know if it sickens the minister, but it sickens this side of the House, and it sickens the public. So can the Attorney General tell this House why her government would rather see this drug-dealing thug, accused drug-dealing thug, walk free than ensure there are enough sheriffs in the courtrooms of British Columbia?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, nobody likes to see a case go unheard and untried, and that is why the different components of the justice system work so hard to make sure that our courtrooms are staffed and running smoothly. We do need to have public confidence in the system. I'm pleased to be able to report, Madam Speaker, that we do have money for new sheriffs. There's $2.67 million in the budget. We have a strong financial position in the province right now. And I have an additional $2.67 million so that we can have two classes of sheriffs go through the Justice Institute this year. One class of 24 will be graduating in May. A class of 24 will be graduating in October. Because, Madam Speaker, as I said, all of the different components of the system need to work together, judiciary, court services, sheriffs, and all of those who manage those people, not the judiciary, of course, but all of those pieces have to work together because what the member is referring to is not satisfactory. Cases need to be heard, and courtrooms need to be ready to hear those trials.
Opposition House Leader on a supplemental.
Thank you. Honourable Speaker, the Minister says we're going to have a new class. Well, guess what, Honourable Speaker? This Attorney General has been occupying that position for the last 4 years. And during that 4 years, we have seen the number of sheriffs in this province decline from over 500 to 420, from 35 to 21 here in Victoria. And adding a class is not going to solve the problem. All components of the judicial system have been working hard. The problem is this government has not been working hard. This government... This Attorney General and this government are guilty of undervaluing the work of sheriffs in British Columbia, Honourable Speaker. This Attorney General and this government are guilty of causing the chaos in our courtrooms, Honourable Speaker. And this Attorney General and this government are guilty of allowing this heroin-dealing thug to be back on the streets, Honourable Speaker. So my question to the Attorney General is, why is she continuing to allow this to happen, and when will it stop?
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, the member opposite referred to the value that people place on sheriffs. Our sheriff services does an absolutely fantastic job in British Columbia. That is why, Madam Speaker, we do not have any difficulty in getting recruits for our sheriff's classes. The sheriffs are extraordinarily well regarded by the judiciary, by the public, and by my ministry. They do a fantastic job keeping our courtrooms safe. And that's why, Madam Speaker, we do need sheriffs. In Victoria this week, there are illnesses, there are a couple of jury trials, so there's a lot of need for resources. But that's why, Madam Speaker, I am ensuring that there will be additional resources in British Columbia with the two new classes that will be graduating this year, another 48 sheriffs coming on stream to keep our courtroom safe.
Opposition House Leader on our final supplemental.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Well, the Attorney General says that they have no difficulty getting recruits. Then perhaps the Attorney General can explain why we have 80 fewer sheriffs now than when she took over her position. Perhaps she can explain why there are 12 fewer sheriffs here in Victoria than when she took over her position. And perhaps she can explain why it's not an anomaly and drug-walking thugs continue to get set free because of the shortage of sheriffs in BC.
Madam Attorney.
Madam Speaker, just to be clear, as I referred to last time I was asked this question, in the case last week, the accused person failed to appear for his own trial on the Monday. He came in for a rescheduled trial on Friday morning. His case was dismissed, but in fact, the resources were available about half an hour later. So that shows, Madam Speaker, because the system works. It is an ever-moving system between the resources and the courts and the time and the scheduling of the courts. That's how every courthouse works in British Columbia, Madam
Members,
Speaker.
The Chair will hear the answer.
And just for clarity, Madam Speaker, at the moment there are 481 sheriffs in British Columbia, and that number will be added to by the two classes that will be graduating this year.